How much time should separate my zinc supplements from my nut consumption? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. So Deb Stewart says, do the phytates in nuts primarily block absorption or bind with the zinc in the nuts themselves? Or if you eat, say, 1/4 cup of nuts, are you crushing your ability to absorb zinc for hours, even supplemented zinc? Tough with a short eating window to get the nuts far from the zinc. So phytate primarily inhibits absorption of zinc and iron. It does inhibit absorption of other things, but zinc and iron are the main concern. Zinc is the number one thing with phytate, because phytate is basically the overwhelming thing that dictates zinc absorption. It doesn't just inhibit the zinc in the nuts from being absorbed. It inhibits any zinc that's taken with the meal from being absorbed. But you have to remember that it might take, 5 hours to effectively put you in the fasting state. But it's not like all the food just immediately spreads through the intestines and stays there and then leaves after 5 hours. So you put something in the stomach, and the stomach isn't really a big open sac where it just falls to the bottom of the stomach. It's really like something that where, the contents are at the upper stomach and then they migrate through over 40 minutes, 20 to 40 minutes. And so then in the intestines, you got to, after 20 minutes of the meal, you started to get a drip of stuff into the intestines, and it migrates down the length of the intestines. So I really think that you don't need to empty the small intestines to separate the zinc. I think you really want adequate space to be like, okay, when the zinc gets into the stomach, everything in the stomach has been cleared, and there's a bit of a gap where the beginning of the proximal small intestine is not still actively swishing around with phytate. I'm going to say like an hour and a half is, the way I usually look at it, if you really want to be serious, is 3 hours after the meal and an hour before the meal. I think that's the simple way to look at it. And yeah, it's hard to fit a window in if you're trying to do multiple doses of zinc. It's actually pretty easy if you wake up, take the zinc first thing in the morning, and then wait an hour. Although coffee does inhibit the absorption of zinc, so that would also mean you have to wait for the coffee. But most people don't eat every 3 hours, so it should be doable to have the nuts, wait 3 hours, then do the zinc. And even if you only wait 2 hours, if 3 hours is impossible, you're still gonna have a lot of distance from the zinc and the phytate if you wait two hours. Because again, it's not a binary thing. It's like everything is continuously moving. So I think you're gonna have a much lower probability of zinc encountering phytate if you take the zinc 2 hours after eating the phytate than if you take the zinc while you eat the phytate. But if you're trying to be maximally conscientious, 3 hours after the meal. All right. Thank you, Deb, for your question. I hope that helped.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. For the remainder of 2020, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.